Hey folks, Free Play Frank. Well, this week I got a video about a cargo trailer that I built. You guys are gonna love that. And then later I'm gonna play a cool song from 1978. Just what I needed by the Cars off their first album. All right, let's get to it. Well, here's the chassis of the trailer. I started putting this together about 6 or 7 years ago, then got busy with other stuff, so it got pushed out of the way. And now I'm gonna get this up to the shop and finish it off. And I've got this. This was a back of a trailer that got into an accident. And you can see the door stand up against the side. It got mashed in pretty good. And it destroyed the loading ramp and stuff. But this body is still in good shape. It doesn't leak. It's been here for, I don't know how many years, probably 8 years or something like that. And I've been using it for temporary storage, which turned into an 8-year temporary storage. But anyways, I'm going to be mounting this little box here on that chassis. We're going to make a little van trailer out of it. Oh, who's this? Oh, hi sweetie. Here's another old trailer. I built this about 10 years ago. This works pretty good, towing behind my car. There you go, sweetheart. Yeah, that's a good place for you to lay down in the sun. Isn't that right, Ashley? Come on, say hi. Hi, Ashley. All right, we got her up by the shop here. Now I gotta repack the wheel bearings and put better tires on it. And you see something happened to this rail here, so that's gonna have to be replaced or straightened. And then I gotta finish building the rear of it, because I want to have a fold-up ramp. I want to have the doors on the box too, but I also want to have a fold-up ramp so I can drive motorcycles or riding lawnmower or something like that in the back of it. And then we're going to make a nice wooden deck on this. And what does it need up at the front? It needs a jack leg. It looks like the hitch is in good shape. It's got safety chains. That's all good. I put that rail on there a long time ago that came with the box. And this box is in pretty rough shape. But I see it needs a bit of patching on the bottom. I have the fenders too. And see, I got it lifted up with the forks here. I'll show you how I moved it. The Bobcat with the forks. I put the long fork extensions on with a pallet on the forks, and it's got picked up by the roof there. And we've got there's that pipe that's up on the top. You can see a plastic pipe that's screwed to the top with U-bolts. You can see the U-bolts sticking up there. That's pretty deadly. I'm gonna cut them off. But I think I'm gonna leave that pipe up there, because you never know, I might have to haul broom handles or something. It'd be good for that, I guess. And see, the bottom of this needs some work, the angle iron. However, this was attached to the truck frame, or to the trailer frame, needs to be repaired and replaced, whatever, to get it ready to drop onto the frame here. So we'll get busy on that now. Well, the back of the trailer was collapsed inward slightly by about 3/8 of an inch, so I set up that jack and these blocks to spread it back out to 5 feet. And I got the piece cut there, ready to be welded in, so just have to reposition the blocks and then we can weld the rear cross member in. Yeah, here's a good trick when you want to hold something in place to weld it. See, I've got this long piece of square tubing here to weld there, and there's no way I can hold that with one hand and tack it with the other. So you just tack this little piece of metal on with one tack, and then when you're done, just bang it off. Another good welding trick, if you have to join two pieces of angle iron together, you put a piece of square tubing or rectangular tubing in the vise and C-clamp it all in place. And you make sure it's straight first, put a straight edge on it or just eyeball it, and now you can tack weld that and it won't move. And then undo it all and weld the other side. Yeah, I don't like this flimsy little piece of angle iron here that they built this out of. I know they built it light so you can tow it with an SUV or whatever, but As soon as you overload the thing or get in an accident, it falls apart like spaghetti. So I'm gonna put these pieces of 2-inch by 1/4 wall angle arm along the bottom. I'll leave this here. This is enough room to slip this in on the back of it. Now weld it along the top here and probably drill some holes through and bolt it too, but I don't think I really have to if I just run about 20 tacks an inch or two long. I'm pretty sure that'll be satisfactory to hold it. Right here's the rails that's gonna hold the wood down. I used a 2x4 as a spacer and put this 2-inch angle, welded it on top the frame and run along there with 2-inch tacks every foot. And then I'm gonna put another piece of angle iron across the back after I get all the wood in and weld that on. We got the lumber laid out. I had to number them all because of this front part that's curving. You see where I got marked here? I'm gonna have to cut all those with a skill saw. And that's also slightly lower here, so I'm gonna have to notch this out at the front like this so that it can slide underneath this. And then at the back, I'll have to cut them all to length. And then I'm going to weld a piece of angle iron over top here. And I'm going to have to cut the back out 2 inches up here. Cut it down 1/4 inch so that it'll sit flat with the back end of the angle iron here. And this is used lumber. Most of it was stored outside under a trailer with a tarp. So there's a few pieces that are a little bit rotten on the end there. But parts that I'm using will be fine once we get it all painted and stuff. And I'm also gonna tongue and groove these. I can't afford to buy tongue and groove deck lumber, so got a table saw, I got a dado head, so I'm gonna tongue and groove them all and then put together with caulking in between them so that when they're driving this in the rain, the water doesn't get inside the trailer. Oh, we got most of the wood done here, and you see I had to cut out all these along the front here with a skill saw and then use a hammer and chisel to break out the piece so that they'd fit underneath this lip here. And when you cut the rabbets into it, or tongue and groove or whatever you call it, you lose a lot of the width of your wood. I'll show you how I did that. And I didn't end up using a dado head, I just used the saw blade, and we cut in this way half the thickness of the board, 3/4 inch, and then 3/4 inch this way, so that they all fit together properly. And of course the boards are slightly warped, so you have to sledgehammer them all in there. Well, not sledgehammer, but like a fairly heavy duty carpenter's hammer. And I took a little bit of an edge off of this one here so that it would fit under this lip here nice and tight. And you see I got more room here, I could take more and I could go this way more if I wanted to, but it's not really necessary. And when you do this, use some scrap pieces of wood to get your depth of your saw blade set, and cut a few and try fitting them together till they fit properly. I don't start with your good wood because it took about probably 4 or 5 tries to get this right. And then when you cut all these 3/4 inch things out, your boards get narrower because they're sliding underneath each other. So then you end up with a gap in the middle. So I got one more 2x6, which isn't quite enough. It's about probably 2 inches too small. So one 2x4, I'll rip the 2x4 down, and that'll fill a gap up here and finish the deck off. Okay, deck is done. I got the rear angle iron welded in. I got her bolted down here. The screws, you see I got the proper deck screws here where they had those thin cross members. And this rear cross that was bent, I replaced it with a piece of thicker metal, so I had to drill through and double nut and bolt it. But she's all done now, so now we move on to getting the van body ready to install on here. Okay, I got this all cleaned up at the bottom here, and I got those angle iron pieces clamped in place. And I cut off these ugly corners here that were all hanging down. So the sheet metal on the outside, I'm going to help fix it after it's on a deck. I'll probably end up cutting certain amount of it off and replacing it with new material. And I got this clamp so that it can still be lifted and sat down on the deck. So we're gonna do that now. Sitting down on the frame here, but see in the corners here it's sitting up kind of high on that ridge at the front, same on the other side, and it's not quite lining up at the back too well. I can get it back another half an inch, I'd be happy. So I'm gonna lift it up again and then trim those two front corners. The big pry bar to lift the front and put a block under there. Get in here with the grinder and cut out the part where it's hitting. Now we'll sit her back down and see how well we can get it lined up. All right, I see clamp the front down with clamps up through the bottom of the holes where the aluminum siding's pulled away, to clamp it down at the front and weld it in place. And for the back, I had to jack it apart slightly to spread the door opening to get the door opening square. And I did the same over here. I C-clamped it down and well. welded it. I reinforced the corners of the door jambs here. And I got all these pieces of wood cut for in the back here, so I can screw through the sheet metal on the outside and have something to screw to. Here's the sheet metal pieces of aluminum that I'm going to use to patch the bottom. The two long ones, one for each side and one short one for each side. And then I made these little corners here. These go around the bottom here to cap this off after. And in order to screw the pieces in, I made this piece here, cut it the width so that I can screw from the outside. I'm going to use these screws here. And so when I screw through the outside, it doesn't push that away from the metal there. It'll just push against this board, which is anchored to the other side. And I'll just keep moving it up one side at a time. Work my way across. All right, this side's on. I got this all screwed down and sealed up. Corner done here. And I got the back section done. See, I had to cut it all and pre-drill everything, fit it all, and I got all the caulking in place. And I'm just gonna run all the screws in now, and then this side will be done. Well, this is the back door. I changed my mind about the combination ramp and door because it's just going to be way too heavy to lift up by myself with this metal framework on there and all that stuff. So I'm just making a new door that's going to hinge, and then the ramp's going to be separate. Anyways, what we ended up having to do is I used 3/4 inch and 1/2 inch plywood. And it's an odd shape, so you can't cut it out of a full sheet of plywood. So I made it with sections here. It's all new plywood. It was all left over for a construction project, so no issues with it rotting. This piece here used to be a shelf, so it's been indoors its entire life. Anyways, what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue it all together and screw it with construction adhesive. And you see these edges here with the gasket. See how they fit on there? And then there's enough room to get the sheet metal from the outside. I salvaged the sheet metal from the old door. Enough room to get that underneath there. Here's a piece of the rotten stuff I cut off the bottom. That fits under there, no problem. So this should work out well. And of course, I'm not worried about this piece in the middle here. I think it adds character to it. It's still gonna have the same amount of strength and save that extra 15 or 20 pounds of weight. All right, the door is now turned over, it's all glued together. Got the sheet metal off the old door sitting on there, and I got these pieces here to put around the edges. This one goes on this side like this, and that one goes on the other side. And I'll have to make one for the bottom because the bottom is going to be slightly different. Here's the piece for the bottom of the door. I just bent it around a piece 2x6 because it's the right width. It's a real thin galvanized tin. It should work quite well. Alright, got the door on. I ended up having to trim 1/2 inch off the bottom before I put that skid plate on to make it fit properly. And I was missing the handle, so I made one. And I put these thin pieces of aluminum, the scraps of aluminum I had left from the side patches there, underneath the handle. I put one under here, and then I put them under the hinges. And see, what I had to do with the hinges is I can't have anybody inside the trailer in the dark waiting for me to pound a carriage bolt through to put the nut and the washer on and tighten it. So I put smaller lag screws to hold it temporarily, and then I'll just open the door and take one out at a time and replace it with the carriage bolt. And the threads don't go all the way to the top of the bolt. It's a shouldered bolt, so I had to put sockets on there so that it's dug into the wood solid and it'll hold it. And we had a problem up at the top. You can't see it, but the rubber gasket in there was folded over and it wasn't closing all the way, so I had to cut it loose and re-glue it at the top there for about 1/3 of the way. So now we're gonna, the other thing is you can see the hinges are at a slight angle downward. That's because it's fairly worn out inside here and I can't get this apart. It's all crimped together and these are special bolts, so I don't have the right socket to get out. So I just pull them down as hard as I can, take up all the slack, and we'll see how that works. I put the fenders on. You see that I got them about 2 inches lower than they originally mounted to this box because I put that flat deck on that trailer frame and I raised it up 2 inches. Got better tires on there. The original tires were junk. Still missing a couple lug nuts. Repacked the wheel bearings. I think it looks goofy with the 14-inch wheels. I might have to put 15-inch wheels on it, but we'll get it going like that for now. I fixed up the front here, had another piece of that aluminum with some caulking, and replaced all these loose screws along these seams in the front here. Well, I built the ramp for it. I used 1-inch by 2-inch square tubing. I chamfered this down so it'll sit flat on the ground when it's down. These pieces of 3/16 flat bar to give it some rigidity at the bottom. And I'm going to add 2 more pieces of angle iron across here in the middle to support the center of the expanded metal. And now I have to make the brackets to attach it to the trailer. Got the ramp on. Okay, here's the hinges that I made, one on each side. It's 2 pieces of steel with a hole, and I made these pins here. A little bit longer than it has to be, but it doesn't matter. See, there's a hole here. I can put a big cotter pin in there or one of those little clip pins with a little clip thing that flips over. I went to the hardware store and they were out of those. So, and to hold it up, I just have this U bolt here that goes around the latch, and then this piece of steel here, and I got to get 2 longer bolts. They have long bolts that are about 1 inch long, and I'll weld a couple tabs so that I can turn it like this. And maybe tack some small chains or cable onto this stuff too, so that it doesn't rattle loose and disappear down the road. So next step now is to get going on cleaning it up and painting it. There, I put the jack leg on here. I had to re-top the holes and never sees everything. Who's this? Oh, hi Faith. This is my little 4-month-old baby goat named Faith. Say hi, sweetie. Everybody wants to see how pretty you are. All right, she's all done. Got her painted. Got a little bit more caulking to do around some of the screw holes. Let's see what the front looks like there. Got the jack leg on. Put reflectors on the edges of the fenders. I'll show you the back door. See, it's opened right now and it's just sitting open like that. There's nothing holding it up except for the hinges, so it stays nice and level. I'm gonna clean up the inside a little bit there, tidy up the wiring. And one thing about where I live is the law says if there's a light on a vehicle, it has to work. So I'm running this with magnetic lights. I have these magnetic lights that are cordless that I'm going to use, so I'm not actually going to wire a light harness on this trailer. But what I am going to have to do is I'm going to have to put a riding mower battery with a switch so that I can turn on the marker lights for running at night. But anyways, show you the door closing here. Kind of hard to do with one hand, but it does work. Go. Well, she's a nice little trailer now. I can use it to do whatever I need to do with it. Okay, the ramp back on. Let's see if I can lift it up with one hand. It's kind of heavy, but all right. Up with one hand. Then I have this bolt here that goes through the expanded metal. I don't think I'm going to be able to put that together with one hand, so I'll show you what that looks like after it's done. Alright, here's the tightening mechanisms I made to hold the wrap up, and I just machined a groove in here on the lathe and used pieces of MIG welding wire, welded these little tabs on so I got something to grab onto. Wire will stop it from getting lost if it comes loose, and I got a piece on here too to hold this. Anyways, that completes that build, and hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks guys for joining me this week, and I'll see you all next time. Take her easy.